Hey, hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Ranjan, and today I will discuss about text vectorization. It's a very important step in NLP. So let's start. So first of all, what is NLP? So NLP is a natural language processing. It's a field of AI, artificial intelligence. It comes under artificial intelligence, and this field uses language, computer science, information engineering, and artificial intelligence. Natural language is a language in which human interacts with each other. Natural language processing, it's a related with the interaction between the computer and the human languages. In NLP, we will train computers or machines to process and analyze large amount of natural language data sets. So that data could be in form of text and speech, audio, anything. It would be natural language. As considering a NLP, it's a process. This process have several steps, and I have listed down the important steps. So first is raw text. So raw text is generally that we will get it as a data set. So it's a first step. It would be raw data. We have to extract information from the raw data. So in second step, we will perform tokenization. So tokenization is a process in which we will create a tokens from the raw text. So in this, first we will convert the paragraph into sentences. And once sentences are formed, then we will create a tokens, or we can say it as words. So first we will convert from paragraph to sentence, then sentence to words. Then after, we will perform text cleaning. And in text cleaning, there are several processes. We will perform stemming, we can perform lemmatization. These are the same thing. If we will perform stemming, then we will be performing lemmatization. So these are the same thing. And we will remove stop words. So basically stop words are like a, and, the, I, we. So these are the stop words. We will remove these stop words. We will remove punctuations, basically commas, full stop, question mark. So we will remove punctuations. We will convert upper cases into lower case character. We will remove the URLs. We will remove apostrophes, and we will split attached words which are attached together, and we will standardize words. Suppose someone has written a so like this, so we will remove extra out and we will convert to into so, and we will decode the data into standard format. So once we have cleaned the text, then we will perform vectorization. And basically, we will talk about vectorization in this video. So vectorization is just a converting alphabets into integers. So I will show you in further slides. So as of now, you can take it as we will convert characters into numericals. And once we have the numbers, then we will apply ML algorithm. And this ML algorithm, it could be for any applications. Like we can perform information extraction, we can perform sentiment analysis, we can perform spam detection, or we can perform language translation. So here I'm taking a very simple example to just get a better clarity of this step. So suppose we have a three sentence. This is our data set. This is our data set, or we can say it's data frame. In this we have three sentence. I like to play football. Did you go outside to play tennis? John and I play tennis. This is our raw data. This is raw text. So first step, we will perform tokenization. So tokenization, I have already explained, we will convert paragraph into sentence and sentence into words. So this is our data. I like to play football. Did you go also to play tennis? John and I play tennis. These are my sentence. Sentence 1, sentence 2, sentence 3. So I have converted paragraph into sentences. And now I will convert into tokens. So sentence 1 has converted into tokens 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a list. This is a list of strings in Python. So this is sentence 1, and by this it would be sentence 2 and sentence 3. So my tokenization is completed. So now I will perform text vectorization. So first of all, why we need text vectorization? As we all know that we have to convert categorical values into numerical values in machine learning algorithm, because machine learning algorithm don't understand English alphabet or categories. Machine learning algorithms understand numbers, which is 0 and 1. So what we do in machine learning, we use label encoding, we use one hot encoding, or we use get dummies. So that all processes converts categoricals into numbers. So but in NLP, we have lot of text. It could be 1 lakh text, but in machine learning, we generally have 2, 3, 4, or 10 categories at most. But in NLP, there are many categories, and all these categories are just a words, English words. So we wouldn't be able to perform these things. So in NLP, we will perform text vectorization. So text vectorization, it would be algorithm. So this would be an algorithm in which input will be tokens and output would be feature vector. So output would be feature vector, and it would having a numbers on numerical form. Here it would be alphabet form, word form, and here would be number form. And we have many types of vectorization techniques. So in this video we will talk about count vectorization, and we have n-grams, TF, IDF, say term frequency, inverse document frequency. In this video I am talking about count vectorization algorithm. So this is our data set. We have three sentences and we have already created tokens, and from the tokens I will select unique words. So from all these words I will select unique word. Here you will see I has come twice, but I will write I only once. So I have written I only once. So these all are my unique words. Now what I will do, I will create a new data frame because I have to write numbers only in that data frame. So I will write like this. So these are all my unique words. So I have written like this, and these are my sentence 1 and sentence 3. So what I will do, I will just see, like in sentence 1, play word comes how many times? So play word comes only once, and tennis 0, 2 1, I 1, and football 1, did 0, you 0, go has not outside, no outside, yes, low, like 0 is on, and 0 end. So same is with this, play yes, tennis yes, 2 yes, I 0, football 0, did 0, 0. Did is 1 and you is 1, go is 1, outside is 1, like 0, John is 0, and is 0. So it will be like this. So now we have created a data frame in which we have only 1 and 0. It could be any number. Suppose in sentence 1 football is coming twice, so we will write 2 here. So now our previous data frame was looking like this. It has alphabets, it has words, and now we have converted into this data frame. It would be new, previous data frame and new data frame. This was my previous data frame, and now my new data frame is looking like this, and we generally call this as document term matrix. So this is count vectorization. So now this was the theory. Now I will perform the implementation in Python. So this is the same example that I have explained. I am taking that example. This is my paragraph, and in this paragraph I am taking example as same. I like to play football. Did you go outside to play tennis? And John, I play tennis. So this is my library, which is NLTK. If you are using this first time, you have to install by pip install NLTK. This is natural language toolkit, and this is pandas, which we were using in machine learning as well. And this is count vectorization, which we have just seen. And this algorithm comes from the sklearn feature extraction.txt, and from the NLTK I'm importing tokenize. Here I'm creating a shortcut for count vectorization as CV. Now I will convert paragraph into sentence. So here you will see these are my sentence. And now what I will do, here I'm creating a X variable, and I'm using CV, which is my count vectorization, and I'm using fit and inserting sentence in this. If you will see, I am typing x.vocabulary underscore, and you will see like it is creating like this. So it has written all the unique variables. If you will see that, and did football, go, John, like, outside, play tennis, to you, this all are the unique variables that we have listed down in our theory. And this number is like it is pointing to the position. If you will see here is and comes at 0, and is 0, and did is 1, so did is 1. It's just a pointing a number to each word. Now I will use cv.transform. CV is my count vectorizer, and transform I'm using an on sentence. So my X will be having a shape of 3.11. Why 3? Because I have three sentences, this one, and this one. And 11 is my unique variables. So it comes like this, and earlier it was not an array. So we have just converted into x.2array. So here it is coming like a array. So it is coming in an array form or a matrix form. This is sparse matrix. We called it as sparse matrix. And here I have printed all the things. This will show me only once at which position it is 1. So this is 0 row, and this is second column, which is 1. And you will see a 0, 5. So 0 at 5. If I need to print the data frame for this, I will use pd.dataframe, and I will use x.2array, and columns I will use features name, which I have written in the above set. So here you will see it is like as we have seen here. So it's the same thing, 0, 1, 2, 0 sentence, 1 sentence, second sentence, and all the positions, and comes how many times in first sentence, did comes how many times in first sentence. So it's a document term matrix. So we have to convert in this form, numerical form, to process this data set into natural language processing algorithms. So that's all in this particular video. I hope you have learned something new today. If this video is informative to you, just like this video and subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed. So see you all in the next video. Till then, goodbye, enjoy, happy learning.